How many times over the past year have you or your brand feel like you need to say something about the different events happening in the world? There's a strategy for that. A global pandemic, economic turmoil, presidential politics, civil unrest. There have been no shortage of current events that have interjected themselves into our regularly scheduled PR and brand promotion activities. How your company responds to these disruptive events can define your brand's image and perception. Here at Gregory FCA, we have several clients in the business of providing financial advice and wealth management services. Like big Fortune 500 brands, these firms are also compelled to respond to the events impacting their firm and clients. Whether you are running an upstart RIA firm or setting marketing strategy for hundreds of advisors, getting the response right has never been more important.
Today, we're going to share with you our best tips and practices for responding to controversy. This includes what not to say, incorporating the company's culture and mission into your communications, finding that balance between internal and external communications, and why silence is sometimes the loudest response of all.
When responding to a hot issue, ask yourself two key questions. How does the event in question involve our company, our specific audience, and our client base? And is this an issue our clients are passionate about and that we as a team are passionate about?
It's important to examine the situation or the event at hand to really decide whether or not it's an issue you want to get involved in. If it's a cause that's important to you or your clients, it may be worth putting together a response to show your awareness. Remember, actions can speak louder than words, and sometimes an ill-timed response or poorly crafted response can have a more negative effect than not saying anything at all.
And consider your response holistically. What programs are you putting into place to address a particular event or situation internally and externally? Is it a situation where you can team up with a nonprofit organization, set up a charity initiative, or donate to a cause? These are all important questions to ask from the very beginning and put into action as soon as you can see if it's something that aligns with your corporate mission. It's important to begin your communication plan by ensuring your response is in line with your company's style, mission, and vision. A great example of a company incorporating this concept in response to the events of last year is our client Girard, an independent RIA firm based in Pennsylvania. At the beginning of the pandemic, they saw the need for increased virtual interactions with their clients and stakeholders. So they began a series of video and town hall style meetings. This initiative aligns with the community-centric values and embodied the commitment to continuing to provide great service and education to their clients.
While neutrality during times of tension can sometimes prevent conflict, it's important to think about how the response you craft, whether or not it reflects your mission and the values of both your firm and your clients. Utilize the tone of your message, reiterate mission statements, and vocalize steps your firm is taking to address the event or situation at hand.
We counsel our clients to be thoughtful with their response to the current events, just as we counsel them to be strategic with a company announcement they're issuing that they'd like media attention for. Consider both external and internal communications in any message. And remember, what is shared internally can be made public at the click of a mouse.
Right. It's not just about communicating with your external stakeholders like clients and potential clients. It's important to think about your internal stakeholders as well, such as staff and partners. Look at the communication tools at your disposal and find a common ground to speak to both the broader audience and those that are close to you and your firm. In times of social upheaval, like the global pandemic, listening is key. Hear what your internal and external stakeholders have to say and make sure to incorporate that into your message. Think carefully, but act quickly and communicate through whichever venue makes the most sense, whether that's video, social media, email campaign, or public relations.
It's more than just what you say, but also comes down to how you share it. We live in a fragmented marketing communications world, so be prepared to disseminate information via a multi-channel approach. Your website should be your hub, but use social media, email, and blog channels to support the sharing of your message. Keeping the audience and the channels available in mind at all times will ensure that your messages are not only clear and direct, but also that they're reaching the majority of your intended audience in an efficient and effective way. Be prepared, strategic, and responsive. That's all the name of the game.
One last thing we'd like to address is silence. Silence can sometimes feel like the right response when something major happens or something controversial happens. However, staying silent is often a tactic utilized to stay out of the limelight and to avoid controversy. Sometimes silence can be deadly.
Injecting your firm's voice on volatile issues can be intimidating, yet necessary. Our counsel is not to worry about being first to say something, but to focus on sharing a view that is consistent with your company's values. Often, it's more important for companies to do something to show support of an issue rather than to simply say something. The action plan comes first, then the statements.
While in some instances, silence may be the best course of action, we counsel our clients to really think carefully about this when crafting their message. We encourage you to revisit some of the tips and tricks we've discussed when thinking about how to react to something that's happened.
We want our clients to ensure that their brand voice remains strong and clear no matter the circumstances.
We would love to hear from you. Visit us at gregoryfca.com and give us a follow on social.